have arrived in Berlin. We are now in the taxi. So if I just say, what's my experience of the whole travelling so far? In Bristol, we booked the long stay car park at the airport. As we drove in, it did say on the website that accessible parking would be clearly signed. That was not the case. Well, we couldn't find it. We drove around a few times. And because we couldn't find it, we eventually just pulled in. And Natasha, my friend with me, she ran after the bus and asked the woman where the accessible parking was. She told us she had found a place for us to park, and then we got on the bus with her. And her name was Dawn, and she couldn't have been more helpful. So she demonstrated the positive attitudes that some people do have. As we went into the airport, we went straight to special assistance, and they sorted everything, took us through, everything went quite swiftly, checked in at the special assistance after departure, and we were told to come back 10 to 12, ready to be boarded, and all that went swiftly. So we got on the flight and everything was fine.
Was onto the plane quickly. They were nice, they were chatty.
We got off the plane on their side, everything was good, and they got us off fine. And again, they were all pleasant, chatty. But then as we came outside, we couldn't get an accessible taxi. Apparently they haven't got one. That's what we were told. And it highlights the attitudes around here that the first two wouldn't take us. They said the chair was too big to fit in the boot, but their cars was bigger than my Clio at home, so obviously they just couldn't be bothered to take us. But now we've got a nice taxi driver, and we're kind of travelling in style, because we've got
massive people carrying.
It's like a big one. It's like 7-seater with leather seats. So far this is our journey, and we're happy. And we'll see you later. Good morning, we are down at breakfast on the second day. We went for a walk after checking in. We went to Brandenburg Gate. There was a huge Christmas tree outside, it was very pretty. And then we went to our first Christmas market, which was called... We can't pronounce it. And it was very pretty. The only issue, it was so heaving. We actually got in free of charge for the same people. But it was so heaving. I think all I saw was people's butts. And there was something going on the stage, but I couldn't actually see it. I couldn't even see how big the market was, because there was just so many people. As Natasha said, she could have just taken me around in circles. I would have had no idea. But once the stalls cleared now and again. We had time to just pop in and actually see the stalls. It wasn't too bad. I still enjoyed the whole atmosphere of it. And now we're ready for another day. We got the map out. And we're mapping out where we're gonna go for the day. So I'll check back in soon. Natasha was pretty clued on with the public transport. So we used a lot of the underground trains, most accessible. I think there was about 10, so we just followed these yellow signs. They were the accessibility signs. We paid before going on. And then it was just the case of finding the platform. The train itself was pretty accessible. There was usually a gap to get on the train though, so I would have struggled without someone with me. But once inside, there was enough room and there was a lot of accessibility features. And you could easily read the next stop. Okay, just a little update. We are now in the Checkpoint Charlie Museum. And we asked the lady at the desk if I could go in. And she said that there is an elevator, so I could only go to the ground floor and not to the second and first. They do have an elevator. She did ring, and because it only fits one person, they need someone on hand, and there was no one available. So I couldn't go at this time. So we asked if there was a discount, and it was £10, it was €10, which works at £10. So £10 for just the ground floor, we thought we'd give it a miss. You would kind of expect them just say it was free of charge just to go to the ground floor, but they didn't offer anything. So I think back home they would have just let you in for free. Since mainly it's their fault for not making it accessible. So now we're not gonna go in, we're gonna go and see what else is available.
You're close to me, but life got in between. Tried to square, not be in there, but said that I should have been. Hold back the river, let me look.
Okay, I gotta vlog this. We have just found a really healthy place to have something to eat. And look what we have ordered. Oh yeah, it's a waffle, a gluten-free, dairy-free. It's got maple syrup. Fruit, it's yummy. I've also got a green juice, which is just vegetables, which will be awesome for my hydration. I haven't drank so much today, water, so this will be exactly what the body needs. So just want to say how grateful I am to have people who actually think about people's health. So I'm gonna go and enjoy my waffle now. Hi, it is snowing. We are in Berlin. I am freezing my butt off, but hey, it's so Christmassy and we're at the Christmas market, like the fourth one that we've been to, and we are just loving our time here. And the snow has made it even better. We're in the disabled toilet, and I'm just gonna show you this because I always complain about the flush at the toilets. Do you know when you get those, it's just like a button, you have to push it in. It's really hard to do, and there's different types, like even the ones on the side, I find it hard to pull it really quick down. But this one, the flush is here. You just press this button and it flushes. How awesome is that? So it's hard to show, like, I want to highlight the good examples. So I stop for a minute and see where you hide. Hold back the river, hold back. Once upon a different life, we rub our backs into the sky. But now we call. Okay, we're at the airport, ready for the flight home. Everything's gone smoothly all weekend. We are lifting all the underground that we went to. But today, instead of taking the taxi back to the airport, we decided we'd go on the underground, be straightforward. But we actually chose the one without the lift. I think there's about 10 or something without lift, and the one we wanted didn't have a lift. And it was cold and it was raining, and we walked what felt like forever. Yeah, it was at least half an hour to the next stop. We arrived there, I basically couldn't feel my leg. So, if you're a wheelchair user, or if you have really bad circulation, I would advise you to not be as stupid as I have been this weekend. But take boots, thermal socks, thermal leggings, whatever you need. Because I've certainly learned my lesson. We're now in the airport, and we're warming up nicely. We've been delayed 2 hours, so I think it's because of the snow that's been back home yesterday. So, like, this airport is heaving. Oh, in front of me, there's just people sitting on the corridor. So just waiting for flights, I guess, to go home. But all's been going good here. We had went through check-in. Good. We had a special assistance. And the guy was from LA and he was really helpful. Took us through, so now we're sitting here, gonna eat our dessert and wait till 11 o'clock. Tonight, so I might check in later, if not, see you at home.